No din but snores the house about, made louder by the o'erfed breast of this most pompous marriage feast. The cat, with eyne of burning coal, now crouches for the mouse's hole, and crickets sing by the oven's mouth, ere the blither for their drought. Hymen hath brought the bride to bed, where by the loss of maidenhead a babe is molded. Be attent, and in this time so briefly spent, with your fine fancies quaintly each, what's dumb in show, how plain with speech. By many a dark and painful perch, for Pericles a careful search is made with all due diligence. At last from Tyre, the most strange inquire, to the court of King Simonides, letters are brought, the tenor these: Antiochus and his daughter dead, the men of Tyrus on the head of Helicanus would set the crown of Tyre, but he will none. The mutiny there he hastes to oppress says to them, if King Pericles come not home in twice 6 moons, he, obedient to their doom, will take the crown. The sum of this brought hither to Pentapolis, our heir apparent is a king who dreamed, who thought of such a thing. Brief, he must hence depart to Tyre. His queen, with child, makes her desire, which who shall cross, along to go. Omit we all their dole and woe. Lycorida, her nurse, she takes, and so to sea. The vessel shakes on Neptune's billow, half the flood, half the keel cut, and fortune's mood varies again. The grisly north disgorges such a tempest forth, that as a duck for life that dives, so up and down the poor ship drives. The lady shrieks, and well anear does fall in travail with her fear. And what ensues in this fell storm shall for itself perform. This stage, the ship, upon whose deck the sea-taught Pericles appears to speak. Thou god of this great vast where filthy surges, oh, still thy deafening dreadful thunders, gently quench thy nimble sulphurous lashes. Oh, how, Lycorda, how does my queen, Lycorda? Lucina, oh, divinest patroness and midwife gentle to those that cry by night, make swift the pangs of my queen's travails. Now, Lycorda.
Now the thing too young for such a place, who if it had conceit would die, as I am led to do. Take in your arms the peace of your dead queen.
How? How, Lycorda?
Great master, do not assist the storm. Here is the last living piece of your queen. A little daughter. For her sake, you must be mad. Take comfort.
Oh, you gods. Why do you make us love your goodly gifts and snatch them straight away?
Great master, even for this charge.
Now mild may be thy life, for a more blustrous birth had never babe than ever was princess child. Happy will follow.
What part, sir? God save you.
Courage enough, I do not fear the fraud hath done to me the worst. Yet for the love of this poor infant, this fresh new seafarer, I would it would be quiet.
Sir, your queen must overboard. The seaward tide, the wind is loud, and will not lie till the ship be cleared of the dead.
That's your superstition.
Pardon us, sir. With us at sea, it has been still, sir, and we are strong in custom. Therefore, briefly yield her, for she must overboard straight.
As you think meet, most wretched queen.
Here she lies, sir,
terrible child bed hast thou had, my dear. No light, no fire, nor have I time to give thee hallowed to thy grave, but straight must cast thee, scarcely coffined in the ooze. Oh, Lacorda, bid Nestor bring me spices, ink, and paper, my casket and my jewels, and bid Nicander bring me the satin coffer. Lay the babe upon the pillow. Hie thee whilst I say a priestly farewell to her.
Suddenly, woman!
Sir! We are set beneath the hatches, tossed in the tomb ready.
I thank thee. Mariner, say what coast is this?
We are near Tarsus.
Alter thy course for Tyre. When canst thou reach it?
By break of day, if the wind cease.
Oh, make for Tarsus. There will I visit Cleon, for the babe cannot hold out to Tyrus. There I'll leave it in careful nursing. Go thy ways, good mariner. I'll bring the body presently.